Hi all, welcome to my channel, welcome to my world. This is The World Away. We've now got issue 29, which is stages 107 to 110 of the Hero Collector and Eagle Moss release of Build the Ghostbusters Ecto-1. Okay, these stages are all to do with the rear of the vehicle. We're going to be doing the rear fenders and we're going to start putting the tail lights onto the main vehicle, which is why it's not on the shelf at the moment, but it will be on there at the end of this video. Now, we did get the replacement door. Now, they did say it was going to be coming in 107, and it does. And as you can see on the screen here, this is what they look like side by side together. And this is what it looks like fitted to the car. I also did a change that everyone was shouting at me last time with the rear vents on the car as well. I put them upside down. As you can see, I've now put them the right way around. But you see, I make these mistakes so you don't have to. Now, if you want to get this for yourself, I'll put the link down here to the Hero Collector and Eagle Moss websites. In the US, follow the US link. In the UK, follow the UK link. You can get this all the way from pack one. But without further ado, let's get cracking. So this is stage 107. As you can see, I've already opened this because this is the stage that had the replacement door in it. And this is everything we got, which is basically the wing section of the rear of the car there. So the first thing we need is this lovely wing section here. This is plastic, but it's perfectly painted. Looks absolutely brilliant. We're going to be attaching the right rear outer light housing, which looks like this. That was a handful. That was a halfer. That was a mouthful. What we're going to do is this has actually got a keyhole pattern on there. It's just going to match the hole that we've got in that side there. So we can just locate that perfectly and secure it in with an AP screw. Make sure that goes in all the way. And that is perfect. So now we have that in there. Then we're going to be putting some trim panels in. Now, the first one looks like this, and it's got three tabs along the bottom. They're going to follow the tabs that we can see along the bottom of the vehicle here. Make sure we put it around the right way. And that fits in perfectly, just like that. Once again, that's going to be held in place, this time with EP screws. So I'll do the middle one first. You will find when you put this on, it does seat itself in. So you're not really going to have a problem lining it up where it goes. I'll put the one at this end. Just over here. And then finally, just one at the other end here. That's perfect. Now we're going to continue with the trim panels. We've got this bit of chrome panel here. Again, this is plastic, but it's going to fit in the shape that we can see there, just behind the rear light housing, like that. Held in from the other side once again with EP screws. Two of them this time. So that's number one. And that's number two. Then we've got this lovely massive trim panel, which is going on the top, which is following the swoosh of this wing. We have got some locating holes in here, which is going to help you locate where that actually goes. But this is going to be fitting in place when we attach it to the next section. So for now, we're just going to leave that over the top. We've also got a little bit of rear trim here, which we don't actually use in this stage. So once again, we're going to keep that to one side as well. But that is all there is to do in that stage. So I will show you what we're doing in issue 108. I forgot to do that last time, but we're going to be assembling a reflector here, and then we're going to be putting the lens into the housing that we created earlier. This is a strange one. We're going to go back to the vehicle then, and we're going to be taking out a VM screw that we got here and replacing it with a WM screw, and then doing that on the other side. Not quite sure why we're doing that. Bit interesting. Perhaps there was a mistake that they found earlier on, but that's something we're going to be doing as well. So this is everything that we've got in stage 108. First thing we need to do is take this massive reflector here, and we're going to be putting a red lens just inside this section here. So as you can see, that fits in perfectly just like that. We're then going to be putting the actual reflector in over the top of that, so it sits flat. Now this is directional, So make sure you put it in the right way. You know that because it's going to fit flat. And we're going to hold that in with AP screws. Just two AP screws here. So one on this side and just one on the other side here. And then we've got a tiny clear reflector which is going to go into the front here. That looks just like this. So we can put that in place and line up the holes of the screws with this, as you can see there. And then that's going to be held in with really tiny screws. These are RP screws. We're going to need three of these. And I'm probably going to have to put my glasses on because they're so tiny. I'm holding it like a pen. Very delicate job this one's going to be. But the first one's gone in perfectly. When you screw these in, it's very hard to show you that this has actually got a grill on it. Now, I put my grill face down. I don't think it matters, but obviously on a real car, you don't have the rough side up, you have the smooth side. So that's what I've done there. But that's that in place. We can put that to one side, and we want to bring over this lovely section that we worked on last time here, because we're going to be putting the lens. Don't worry too much about that, because we haven't attached that yet. We're going to be putting the lens in the back of the light housing here. So that's just a push in. It is quite a tight, snug fit, but when it's in, it should look like that. So I'm going to put all this to one side, because I now need to bring over the bodywork to remove two screws. So this is the large rear window on the right hand side of the car, and the screw they want me to take out is this one just here. Now they said this is a VM screw, and we're going to be replacing it with a WM screw. Now I'm going to look at that and see what the difference is. And looking at the WM screw here, it actually just seems the same thickness and stuff, just a bit shorter. It's a bit weird. So I'm doing what they told me to do. That's the WM screw in place. And we're just going to do the same on the other side. I've just realized actually that when I took that out, that screw was actually not all the way in, and that's why they've got the shorter screws in here, because it didn't fit flush to the panel. But there you go, that's in place, and that's all there is to do in that stage. So in stage 109, we're going to be doing the right rear fender. So we need this section here, and once again, like we did first off in this pack, we're just going to need the housing to put over the rear section here. And it is directional again. You have got a little keyhole pattern in there. Just like that. That's going to be held in with an AP screw. And that's the housing in place. And just like last time, we have got a lens to put over the top of it. So that's just going to go in like that. Now we're going to need to light this up. Now to do that, we need to take LEDs are from the back of the rear of the vehicle, and they look just like that. They've got two LEDs on, and as you can see, labeled R on the wire. So the top LED here is going to be going into the lens we've got on the first piece that we had here. And all you've got to do is just push that in. Now you would think that when we put this in, it would be easier to take the housing off. But even if you take it off, you have got this recess to actually go in. So it's not really going to make things easy at all. So what you need to do is actually just bend the wire up just a little bit. And then use some flat nose tweezers to help push that into place. Just going to be putting a little bit of oil around the inside, just to help lubricate that up a bit for when I slip that in. I've got it in the cavity. Now don't think for one second that that wasn't hard, but you'll hear it click and it needs to go all the way in there like that. Now putting the wire around like this, we've got the rear bit of trim that we had previously, and that's just going to go over the two pegs that we can see there and sit in like that. You can push that over those. And then holding that gently, we're going to be putting the other lens into the other side here. So once again, I think this is going to be a bit of a challenge. Bend it up 90 degrees. I am going to put a little bit of oil again just around the LED this time, and I'll get this put in.
Now I've got it in, but I haven't got it in all the way. I'm just gonna keep pushing it until I get it to where I want it. There we go, that's in all the way now.
You know it's in the way because there's no way that's just gonna fall out on its own. Once again, I'll just replace that trim panel that just fell off there. Now we're gonna be piecing both of these pieces together. So once again, I'm gonna put the trim back on that I took off earlier, just onto this side. And then we're gonna sandwich these together. When you do that, you want to sort of push the LED's wires through the little gap just in there on that bit of trim. That's in. Just checking everything is fitting perfect. Nothing's pinched, and that is now in place. So the first screw I'm going to put in, which is pretty much holding this whole thing together here, is an NP screw. So when I've got this one in, I will just adjust the trim at the top, which as you can see has come out. But that's going to hold that, and now it will enable me just to move this around. So now I've got this one in at the top here, I want to put a screw in there, and that's going to be a WP screw. Tiny screw, that one. There we go, that should piece those two bits together. We've got an MP screw just down the middle here. And this time I can make these ones really tight. Go back to the first one, just tighten that one up as well. Which means the last one is just down this end here. Now we're going to be adding the fender part. So this is the first part that we're going to be putting in, and this is just going to go over these two holes we see here. So this is just going to approach this from this direction like that and fit on like that there. That's going to be held in with EM screws. Now this time, all of these parts here that you'll see me using are metal. So I have just put this in a little bit of oil. Just a 3-in-1 oil. It's just a general purpose 3-in-1 oil. So there's the first EM screw. And that's the second one. I'm just bringing up my part work upgrades mat because we need the part that we had in the last pack, because we're going to be putting a couple of cable tidies in place on there. Now the cable tidies look just like this, and basically we're going to have one going on this section just here, and it's held in with an XM screw. This is actually a really, really involved stage. I didn't realize that. I thought we'd be whizzing through this pack, but yeah, this one is a little bit tougher. So there we go, that's the first clip in place. And then we've got one more just to go onto the same point just down this side here. Probably better to actually just put the screw in first, then offer this to that, slot it down like that, and then tighten it up. So that's the clips in place. Now we've got the wheel arch to put in. That's just going to go into the three lugs that we can see there, over the top like that, held in with EM screws. And once again, I've got them here, and we'll put three of these in place. That's one. Two. And three. Now we're going to be taking this section here, which we've been pretty much working on since the start of this pack here. This is going to go over the smaller of the holes here. So this is going to go in like this. There. And that's held in with three DM screws. So I'll put the center one in first. make that tight, and then just do the other two. That's the second. And finally, the third one's all the way down here. So there we go. That looks just like that. Lovely lines on this. That's what it looks like from the back. And we're about to put a reflector just in that hole there. This is the reflector we worked on earlier on. So just attach this to the vehicle. It's going to line up the holes. Like that. Does actually fit quite nicely in there, but we are going to hold that in from this side here. We've got two sort of holes there to put it in, and they are IP screws. Definitely an involved stage, this one. So that means I've got to bring the vehicle up now, and we're going to be actually tracing the door switch through that panel as well. This is going to be fun. So I brought the car up now, so we're going to be attaching this panel to the car, but what we need to do is the door switch, this one here, needs to follow the route of these clips that we put in earlier for the cables. So got one in there. You want to make sure it's not pinched. That's the main thing. One in this side over here, and then both of these cables here are just going to go off down the bottom in that direction there. Now, I know this is hard to see, but we don't want them pinched in that section here. And then when we're happy, we're going to be offering this to the car. So hold your breath. Make sure nothing's pinched there. And we'll put this on. Just like that. That's perfect. What we're going to do now is turn the car upside down, and we're going to be attaching that with quite a few screws. This middle column here, at the top two here, are going to be taking IM screws. So I'm going to put them in first just to hold that panel in place. Right, the next IM screw is going directly underneath it. This is so hard to film, I have to say. But we're getting there. And then I'm going to be putting IM screws in these two here and these two here. So there you go, as you can see, that's six IM screws in. Just going to tighten this one at the top here. Now in these five holes down the bottom, we're going to be putting NP screws. And there we go, that's all the NP screws in. And the final screws we're going to put in are just into these door sections here. And they are YM screws. And there we go, that's all in place. Now before I turn it over, there is one more screw to put in, and that's just at the back here, in this section here, which is an IM screw. IM screws here and at the top. Then we've got NP screws down the bottom, and finally on these two sides here, we've got YM screws. Now I may as well keep the mat down here, because in the last stage, really easy for us, we're just going to be doing the left rear fender and skirting, which means we're just putting one part on another, nice and easy. So to do that, just like we did for the right-hand side one, this is the left one, this is just going to go on top here, this is metal. Turn it over, and that's going to be held in with BM screw. Now it is metal, so I will put it in some oil, but that's the first one, that's the second one, and that is all there is to do in that pack. Now I did say on my live stream that I wasn't going to be putting the top on the bottom anymore, but I think it would be rude not to now, won't it? So what I'm going to do is I'm going to put them together, and then I'll get my phone out and show you what that looks like. But I'm just looking at it down here, it looks really impressive. Check this out. So I fed all the wires out the back, so they're not going to get pinched here, but there you go. That looks pretty amazing, including the new door in there. What an amazing pack that was. So we've got one side of the vehicle complete now. There we go. Look, it's back on the shelf now, and you can see that lovely rear of the vehicle. So it's there for prosperity for all time now. But that was really good. It's stage 109. That was a little bit fiddly, but we got there in the end. Now, if you want to get this for yourself, once again, put the link down here. If you're in the US, follow the US link. If you're in the UK, follow the UK link. But I really do hope you liked that video. If you did, please remember to give me a thumbs up. And if you haven't subscribed already, and remember, it's now 48% of you haven't subscribed already. So please, please click that subscribe button for me, and you'll be notified every time a new video's up. Other than that, take care.